Everyone, this is the third part of the chapter, Pastoralists in the Modern World. By now, you have learned about the Indian pastoralist communities and the changes brought up in their life by the colonial rulers. Now, let's move to the Africa, where over half the world's pastoral population lives. Even today, over 22 million Africans depend on some form of pastoral activities for their livelihood. They include communities like Barber, Maasai, Somali, Boran, Turkana. Like pastoralists in India, the lives of African pastoralists have changed dramatically over the colonial and post-colonial period. What have these changes been? So we will be discussing some of these changes by looking at one pastoral community, the Maasai, in some detail. The Maasai cattle herders live primarily in East Africa. 3 lakh in southern Kenya and another 1,50,000 in Tanzania. We will see how new laws and regulations took away their land and restricted their movement. This affected their lives in times of drought and even reshaped their social relationships. Many problems which they have faced, the most prominent being continuous loss of their grazing ground. This has many reasons. Scrabble of territorial possession in Africa, dividing the region into different colonies, best grazing grounds being taken over by the white settlements, grazing ground being converted to cultivated land, national parks and game reserves. Where have the grazing lands gone? In Africa, Maasai lost 60% of their pre-colonial land by the hands of whites. They were forbidden to enter into white locality. The restriction and confinement to semi-arid areas with frequent drought made their life difficult and they lost half of their livestock within 2 years. Large areas of grazing lands were also turned into game reserves like Masai Mara, Samburu National Park in Kenya, Sengreti Park in Tanzania. In 1885, Maasai land was cut into half with an international boundaries between British Kenya and Tanganyika. In 1990, Tanganyika came under British rule after the defeat of Germany in World War I. It attended independence in 1961 and united with Zanzibar to form Tanzania in 1964. Borders were closed. With the redrawing of borders, the movements of all the pastoralist communities were severely restricted. They were required to get special permits in order to move. Getting a permit was often difficult. People were punished for breaking the rules. Like Maasai, other groups were also restricted to live in a confined areas. Drought affected their lives. Later, Maasai society was divided into two social groups, elders and warriors. Elders formed the ruling group who met in periodic councils to decide affairs of the community and settle disputes. The warriors consist of young people mainly responsible for the protection of tribe and organized cattle raids, which was considered a wealth. The Britishers imposed restrictions on raiding and warfare and even appointed chiefs of different subgroups of Maasai, who were made responsible for the affairs of the group. Due to the interference of colonial government in the social system of Maasai, change occur at two levels. The traditional differences based on age between the elders and warriors was disturbed. A new distinct between wealthy and poor pastoralists was developed. So we can conclude with that pastoral communities in different parts of the world was affected in a variety of different ways by changes in the modern world. New laws and new borders affected the patterns of their movement. With increasing restriction on their mobility, pastoralists find it difficult to move in search of pastures. Pastoralists was not relics of the past. They are not people who have no place in the modern world. Environmentalists and economists have increasingly come to recognize that pastoral nomadism is a form of life that is perfectly suited to many hilly and dry regions of the world. I hope you understood the chapter. Thank you.